2K Sports Pregame Show, sponsored by Kia.
Hello, everybody. Glad you could join us here on 2K Sports. I'm your host, Ernie Johnson. Next to me, Kenny the Jet Smith and Dr. Shaquille O'Neal. Tonight, it'll be the Memphis Grizzlies up against the San Antonio Spurs. Well, for San Antonio, playing under 500 basketball over the last 10 games, they can do better, and they'll try to get on the winning side tonight. And you take a look back at the Spurs, not just last season, but what they've been able to do for decades now. Shaq, are we witnessing one of the best stretches of any sports franchise?
Yes, I've been beaten by this team. I've beat this team. To have sustained success like the Spurs, it's rare, Ernie. I don't care what sport you're talking about. It started with one of my favorite players, the Admiral, and the young Tim Duncan. But now they're set up for the future. Sugar K. Leonard is the man in San Antonio.
Well, I'll tell you, we'll look back in 20 years if we're still alive at that time and just shake our heads wondering, how did they do it so long? I mean, this Spurs team is a franchise to model your franchise, not just in basketball. If you're a business, go to the Spurs seminar and you'll learn how to have a great business.
Well said. That does it for us. Kevin Harlan with the call, and we will see you later.
From Memphis, Tennessee, Kevin Harlan here along with analysts Greg Anthony and Steve Smith, and we'll be hearing from T.A. along the sideline all game long. For the Memphis Grizzlies, they won their last contest, that game against the Hawks in Atlanta, and there wasn't much question as to how that game was going to turn out. They absolutely put the hammer down on them.
I mean, no stress in that one. The game almost looked like a shoot-around for them. Amazing at how well they shot the basketball.
It sure seemed like everybody on the team was in the zone. It'll be interesting to see if they are able to keep up that sweet shooting stroke.
And with pregame routines coming to an end, we're just about ready for our tip-off. First, though, let's get a report from the sideline and say hello to David Aldridge.
Well, the development of Kawhi Leonard and the addition of LaMarcus Aldridge have energized the vets on this team and extended the Spurs window. Tony Parker said, "It definitely helps that Kawhi and LaMarcus are here and playing great. It makes me want to be here to help all the young guys. It's such a great family and such a great atmosphere that it makes you want to stay." Kevin?
Thanks, D.A. The players who are part of that organization seem to want to stay in San Antonio. And the Spurs organization, really the gold standard in the NBA. Greg, they just keep winning.
You have to be impressed with how they've acquired young star talent to kind of carry on
ready,
that
gentlemen.
Tradition. Usually
ready.
When teams have their stars retire, they go through that rebuild phase. The Spurs only revamp and reload.
All right, let's set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. On the court for San Antonio, Parker and Green, the tried and tested backcourt. Leonard and Aldridge, the two stars at the three and the four. And it's Gasol at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Fres with the ball. Gasol covering, and they're able to recover. Another shot, and Randolph with the layup. Randolph's got the first points of the night for the Grizzlies.
And the defense has no answer for Zach Randolph. When he gets that deep inside, he just excels at scoring over them.
Here's Parker. An amazing finish with a hand right in his face.
You know, huge height advantage there, but because of the great body control, he's able to cancel it out.
He also understands better than most how to use angles, and that was the reason why.
Fred. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
And can you always depend on him or what to lead you to the right place with that pass? Money.
Knocked away. And look at Prez there, just punishing the rim.
Oh, and you love the ferocity that Prez finished that playoff with. No layups for the big fella.
Parker kicks to Green. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. And it's denied.
And Parsons with a heads-up play on defense.
about a minute and a half through the first quarter. Leonard, the pass to Parker. At the elbow, it's Gasol. Down to five on the shot clock. Here's Leonard.
Nice footwork from Parsons, able to bother that shot.
Leonard, no luck.
You ask his teammates, Marc Gasol is really the catalyst for the Memphis Grizzlies. He's the defensive anchor and also the focal point on the offensive end.
And no doubt, Gasol, the engine of this team, Steve, but he maintains a very humble demeanor, don't you think?
A star, but also you can label him as a great teammate. He stands up for his guys, he bonds with them, puts the team first. That's what you want from your best player.
Free throw good from Prince.
And Prince is just brilliant. Just has such remarkable initiative and moves well without the ball.
Both free throws good from Prince. Spurs have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Gasol a screen. Parker outside. Once again off the mark by San Antonio.
Really just struggling here in the first few minutes. Five attempts with only one falling.
And Parsons kicks to Randall. Passes it to Young from about 19 feet. And he hits the jump shot.
And really, Young is never going to pass up a catch-and-shoot opportunity. He's remarkably efficient with those kinds of shots.
Now here's Parker. He's playing a pretty big role for him at the offensive end, averaging about 12.5 points a game. He gives them a double-digit lead. And it's 8 points for Prince.
Oh, great ball movement there.
Parker kicks to Green. Randolph against Aldridge. Oh, there are a lot of great players in the NBA that come off the bench, act as the sixth man for their team. Who would be your pick right now, Steve, for the best sixth man in the NBA?
I think this award has his name all over it. Jamal Crawford. And then a guy,
but he's 37 years old, or 38 years old.
Every year, he's either one, two, or three in my vote. I mean, it's amazing he's been doing it year after year.
So many different teams, so many different cultures. But he seems to adapt every place he goes.
And he still looks like he's like 22 years
old.
Isn't
that amazing? Mm-hmm. And loves the game.
Yeah.
He has great zest for the game. And here is Prince following the three-pointer by Tony Parker. Young dishes to Randolph. Down low. Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first. And the wide-open shot from Green. And it's off from three-point range. And the Grizzlies leading by 9. Parsons outside. Randolph passes to Prez. Parker with the steal. Outside Leonard. Down low. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
The Spurs shooting their initial free throws of the game right here.
And they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
And the first one at the line is good. So Memphis ends up going with a new group. So San Antonio going with an almost entirely new group here. Dwayne Dedmon's checked in for Gasol. Kyle Anderson comes in for Leonard. Ano Ginobili's checked in for Green, and it's Mills in for Parker. Both free throws good for Mulder.
He just can't miss from the line right now. He is the guy you want taking those shots.
Conley kicks to Ennis. Back to Conley. To the inside. Davis. It's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Really, the right play defensively. If you can't block, force them to the line.
The Grizzlies shooting their 3rd and 4th free throw shots of the night.
Deontay Davis. 2 shots.
He misses the free throw. Bertinus, he's checked in for LaMarcus Aldridge. That one is no good. Spurs trail by 7. There's 39 seconds left to play in the first. Ginobili attacking. Good on the baseline, Jay.
Once he realized who was on him, he confidently went straight up and sunk that easy look.
Dishes to Ennis. 21 seconds left in the first quarter. Five on the clock. Daniels dishes to Davis. From 17 feet out, Hills with the rebound.
I like that shot for him, though. Very little defensive pressure. He typically rises up and buries that.
Knocks down the three ball. And still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. Grizzlies lead by 2. The second quarter coming up right after this break, so don't go anywhere. Gasol brothers, Powell, talked about the joy of sharing the NBA stage with his brother, Mark.
It's like a dream come true. It's hard to really picture it. I'm just proud to be Mark's brother, and I'm proud of what he's become as a basketball player and as a man.
Well, their story is a bit like a fairy tale, the way two of them, sons of medical professionals in Spain, have become two of the best centers in the NBA at this age.
Especially when you remember what a raw talent and how big and bulky Marc Gasol was when he was drafted by the Lakers. I mean, they traded him to Memphis for his brother, and that does all seem like fiction, doesn't it?
So far, it's been a closely contested game as we get the second quarter up and going. And looking at what we've seen from the Grizzlies, what do you guys think?
They come out the gates here strong and put together just a solid first quarter.
And that's exactly how you want to start this one off. They open this one up with a real bang.
On the court for San Antonio here in the second. Mills and Manu at the guard. Dwayne Dedman is out there with Anderson. And it's Bertinus in at the three. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, after suffering a hip injury in Texas, LaMarcus Aldridge spent 2 months shooting from a chair, and his form improved dramatically. Now his go-to move is his fadeaway high-release jumper. It's an unstoppable shot, and Aldridge is so confident in it, he says, once the shot's up, I'm getting back on D. Kevin?
Thanks, D.A. He's got a great touch. And it's blocked by Conley. Just over a minute gone here in the second quarter. Right, left side. Daniels kicks to Conley. Here's Wright. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Inside is where Wright feels at home. Love his length and soft touch.
Mills passes to Anderson. Ginobili. Great pass to set up the lay-in.
They love getting simple looks like that inside.
Feeds it to Daniels. Back to Conley. Right side. Shot by Ennis. Nobody around. No good on the triple. Spurs trail by 5. Here's the pass to Bertinus. He dishes it to Mill. Pass to Dedman. Shot clock at 5. Three-pointer. Mills can't hit.
I I am wondering, what can he do to get it cranked up? Nothing from long range this quarter after hitting one in the first.
Memphis moving it around. Ennis kicks to Conley. To the middle. Here's Davis. He gets it in there.
And I love the fact that he didn't have to slow down or adjust there. The pass was just timed perfectly.
And Smitty, when you were a young player in the league and taking on the great legends of the 90s, were there any games where you were just in awe of who you were on the court facing?
A lot, Kevin, but some names that come to mind was first Michael Jordan. Going up against the great Michael Jordan. A lot of people say they played against Michael, but he played the two-guard position.
Right at
and
you,
I
huh?
had to guard
oh,
him,
my gosh.
And he was guarding me. And then growing up in Detroit, got a chance to work out with Isaiah Thomas, Joe Dumars, and then compete against these guys. Those are the three names that come to mind. I think those are the three that really had an influence on my game.
And the single most difficult guy for you to cover?
By far. I couldn't cover him. That was Michael Jordan.
And who was a guy that was the best defensive player on you, guarding you?
And he was a teammate of mine, so a lot in practice. But then when we got traded and separated, Stacy Alden, the Plastic Man,
yeah.
was a guy I had problems with.
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice steal. And then how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And Greg, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play defensively.
When your defense translates into offense, it's a beautiful thing.
Spurs trail by 9. Parker dishes to Aldridge. Back to Parker. He kicks it to Gasol. And it's good on the assist by Parker.
Yeah, and that's what you want from your point guard. Parker distributing the ball wonderfully on that possession.
Gasol passes to Young. Parker with the steal. Shoots. But they'll get another chance. Gasol kicks to Green. Parker outside. At the elbow, it's Aldridge. Drains it from 17 feet out.
You know, as soon as he recognized the height mismatch, he immediately pulled up for the jump.
The mid-range jump shot, he's so comfortable. He's got such a great feel from that distance.
Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
You're better than that.
Thank you, Kevin, boy.
Well, Prez, in their last game against the Hawks, had a huge game. He scored 23 points, and in addition to his scoring, he also finished with a season high in rebounds. He absolutely stole the show. It felt like he was everywhere all the time. It'll be interesting to see how he follows it up, Kevin.
Okay, Dave, thanks. Any chance we see him top that performance right here tonight?
You know, I can't imagine he'd be able to pull off that kind of an outing 2 games in a row. But, hey, that's what the truly great ones are capable of doing.
The great ones do it night in and night out. So far, he's doing it in this stretch run.
And some changes here for the Grizzlies. Randolph comes in for Davis, and Baldwin subbed in for Chandler Parsons. Leonard hits them both.
Well, going into the 2011 draft, the Spurs said it was a tough decision to trade away George Hill in exchange for the pick that became Kawhi Leonard. No remorse on that one now, though. Once again, the Spurs struck gold as Kawhi has developed into a true superstar. And Prez scores from anywhere, inside, outside. This guy does it all.
Leonard dishes to Parker. Aldridge against Randolph. Aldridge is screened. Gasol setting the pick for Leonard. Once again off the mark by San Antonio.
They'll probably let the clock wind down here.
I think you're right, but so often we see teams who aren't thinking about it.
The feed now to Gasol. Leonard with the steal. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. From 10 feet out, San Antonio again missing. Young. No good on the buzzer beater. And the first half comes to a conclusion in a game that has been very close so far. Grizzlies out in front. They're up by 5. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Greg Popovich. Pop, what do you think was the main issue during the first half?
We didn't make shots.
Thank you for that insightful analysis, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half momentarily.
Let's go, guys. We're leading, but we need to work harder if we're gonna win this game. Look, I'm fine with our defensive effort, but I know we could be doing so much better on offense. Hey, let's give ourselves a chance in this next possession. Here we go. I want us to spring our man with the screenplay here. Look for the pass as you clear the pick and let it fly. Stay focused, gentlemen. Let's go.
Doesn't the Mississippi River look simply spectacular in the moonlight here tonight? Welcome back, everyone, to Memphis. Well, both sides have assessed what they need to do over the break in halftime. We'll see now if one can pull out away here in the third. We're seeing a tremendous game from Prez.
Yeah, created a lot of quality shots for himself in that first half, and he knew when to pass it up when the double team came.
Just awesome on-court awareness, knowing when to take it to the hole as well as dish it out. That's why he is such a crucial member to this team.
Down low, the tough pair of Zebo and Gasol. Prez out there with Young, and it's Parsons in at the small forward. And that's the group for David Fizdale as we begin the second half. Steve, now that it's all said and done, when you look back in your career, do you have one of those single moments that stand out as your favorite?
Yeah, I think my favorite for me is probably on draft night. And then I think the moment that it retired. So everything in between, and the good and the bad. A lot of people point to the championships and all-star and the gold medals. But I think the relationships, the ups and downs, the injuries, just everything, it shapes you as a young man.
One of the, going with the saying that the journey is the reward.
It's totally right, Kevin. I mean, that journey, a lot of people don't get a chance to have that journey. So you want to appreciate even the things that didn't go so well.
Yeah, great perspective. And so Marc Gasol nails both of them.
In terms of big man, he is certainly one of the better free throw shooters in this league.
Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sidelines.
Well, guys, we know Greg Popovich uses a lot of different tools to motivate his players. Sometimes it's the things he doesn't say that works best. Popovich said, sometimes in timeouts, I'll say, I've got nothing for you. We just turned it over six times. Everybody's holding the ball. What do you want me to do? Figure it out. Now get up and walk away. Because it's true. It's on them. Kevin?
Thanks, D.A. That accountability goes a long way. That leading by seven, and Young kicks to Prez. Pass to Randolph. Poked away. Gasol passes to Young. Tries from 10. Hits some rim on the way in, and the bucket's good. Young's got seven.
Yeah, and Young has a beautiful touch from the mid-range, really sticking it to the D from there.
Nobody near Leonard, and it's good on the assist by Parker. Parker's got his third assist on the night. And for Memphis, they're shooting so well, 63% the offense working as one cohesive unit. And there's the basket. Whistle blows and a chance for a three-point play going to the line for one.
Yeah, he earned that one. I mean, taking the hit and still able to get that one to go down.
Some changes for Memphis. Brandon Wright's checked in for Gasol. Ennis comes in for Young. And Mike Conley is subbed in for Prez. So San Antonio going with an almost entirely new group here. Dwayne Dedmon's checked in for Gasol. Anderson comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. Ano Ginobili's checked in for Green. And it's Mills in for Parker.
You know, over the years, Zach Randolph has proven to be the perfect leader. He commands respect, and he gets it from his teammates.
Now here's Leonard. He has six. Ginobili, that's for two. Oh, and that one had the right spit on it, and it is good. Ginobili's got his third basket of the night. The dish now to Ennis. Kicks it to Randolph. rebound by the Spurs. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Blazers.
And despite the outcome, I think they'll feel a little better about that game. There are a lot of positives that they can take away from that performance.
Hey, at times you have games like that, but it's all about taking those good things and doing them consistently for an entire game.
And hard work on the glass. Once again, guys, they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard.
The Tar Heel alumni, Brandon Wright, you know, he's an efficient scorer inside. He has a great reputation as a dependable role player.
First trip to the line for him here.
Two shots. Now, gentlemen, two shots. Loose shots.
And he can't get the first one. Troy Daniels, he's checked in for Zach Randolph. The Spurs also with the sub. Berchtesgaden has checked in. And he's good on the second. So it's the Spurs now. They trail by 9 points. They just couldn't come out on top last time they took on the Grizzlies. That one was played in Memphis.
Yeah, and looking back at their last game against this club, they were badly out-rebounded.
Now here's Mills. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game. Just 5 on the clock. From deep 3-point range, rebound by Ennis. Memphis leading by 9. Outside Conley, he feeds it to Daniels. Pass to Parsons. Ennis kicks to Conley. Wright sets a screen. Outside Conley. The three. That shot missing. And the Spurs going the other way now. There's 1:54 left in the third. Here's Anderson. And it's good. Walk through contact. It's the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
How about that one? Able to maintain control and finish the play.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
And his average at the line stands at about 79% right now. So solid numbers in that department.
Baldwin, he's checked in for Memphis. Spurs also with the sub. Leonard's checked in. Memphis leading. Now Daniels. Dishes it to Parsons. Feeds it to Conley. The pass to Wright. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Rebound San Antonio.
Really bad mental lapse by the defense. Yet he did not make them pay, surprisingly.
San Antonio again missing. Pass to Daniels. Tries a 3. Mills with the rebound. Mills has got his 3rd rebound tonight. Outside, Ginobili. Good on the triple. Ginobili's got 5 points now this quarter. And the Grizzlies leading by 3. Pass to Baldwin. Outside, Conley. Daniels passes to Baldwin. And he can't answer back. The 3-pointer offline. They time it right. They can end this quarter with a 2-for-1.
And that's how you want to end the quarter.
Gedman dishes to Ginobili. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot 2.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
The Spurs have been good at the line so far. 5 of 5. Falls for Ginobili. And some changes here for the Grizzlies. Marcus Alls checked in for Parsons. Young comes in for Troy Daniels. And Prez is subbed in for Mike Conley. San Antonio also making some changes. Pau Gasol has checked in for Dwayne Dedmon. LaMarcus Aldridge comes in for Anderson. And Tony Parker subbed in for Patty Mills. And so both from the line. Memphis has gotten blank from three-point land so far in the third. Still 0 for 3. Memphis moving it around. The feed to Prez. Count it from 12. Prez has got 12 points in the game.
And it's great to see Prez in attack mode, just wanting to shoot the ball every time he's open.
Now here's Parker. He's covered closely. He dishes it to Aldridge. From 15 feet away, and that one is off. It's still anybody's game as we've reached the end of three. Grizzlies lead by three. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports. A chance now to hear Greg Popovich talking to his team just moments ago.
Let's play even smarter and make sure we play harder than them. Yeah, let's go.
Step out.
One, two, three.
Defense.
Mentally, physically, Greg Popovich wants each guy to try and elevate his game.
Yeah, a lot of that starts on the defensive end. That's where the tone is set. It literally ripples through everything else they do.
We welcome you back to what has been a good one here as we get into the fourth quarter. On the floor for San Antonio, the defensive duo of Green and Leonard make up the perimeter. Aldridge out there with Pau Gasol, and it's Parker in at the point. And now running up the court, Leonard pushing it up. Young against Green, outside Gasol. A three from Leonard. It's rebounded by Memphis. Gasol's got four rebounds in this game. Prez, no good. Spurs trail by three. Leonard kicks to Parker. Parker double team. Back to Leonard. From the wing. Another miss by Leonard.
And at a time, they really need him to shoot well. The exact opposite is what's happening.
And Young kicks to Gasol. And good. Got the angles that time as it falls. Gasol's got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for Memphis. Parker outside. He kicks to Aldridge. Back to Parker. Aldridge against Randolph. Good on that shot, and with that, the Memphis lead is cut down now to just three in the basket from Gasol.
Yeah, nothing too fancy. Just getting the job done when they need to make every possession count.
Now here's Gasol, and that's out of bounds. Memphis will retain possession.
Yeah, that's a super defensive play. If that gets through, no doubt they score.
Absolutely. Prevented an easy bucket. Fantastic D.
Chandler Parsons, he's checked in for James Ennis. Prez with the ball. Covered by Parker. The kick out to Young. It's stolen by Green. Leonard on the wing. To the paint. Looking for Gasol. He gets it there. With the second effort. Rejected by Gasol.
Love how Gasol patrols the court. Always on the lookout to reject a shot.
Outside, off the pick, second shot opportunity, and the whistle blows as the basket counts, and a three-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up. All right. He ties it up.
And over the years, Gasol has proven himself to be a valuable teammate, someone guys love to be around, a guy that plays well with just about anybody.
And Young kicks to Fred. And another miss by Memphis. For San Antonio, they've gone just 33% from the field in the fourth quarter so far. They are 2 of 6. Outside, Green. Here's Parker. Good, and the assist goes to Gasol. 7 points for Parker.
Huge shot by Parker there at a moment when his team needed one. A big-time player who welcomes any challenge that comes his way.
Now here's Fred. Parsons passes to Gasol. And he wills that one in, sinking right through off the back iron.
Gasol demands the ball when his team needs an important basket. Just remarkable initiative on his part.
For San Antonio, they've gone 3 of 7 from the floor in the fourth. That's a 42% mark in the quarter. Goes up on the wing, and it's San Antonio with another.
And that they need those points, and I bet he's the guy that continues to go for it.
He will use his size, his skills, and his shooting ability to go get this win.
Now here's Fred. Passing there by Memphis. That ball is good for another field goal. His sixth. He is 6 for 9 in the stat sheet.
That's what Perez does. You need a big bucket. He knows how to deliver.
Parker dishes to Aldridge. Stolen by Randolph. And here we go. The Grizzlies on a fast break. Perez leading the charge. In the corner, Parsons with it. Three-pointers off the mark. For San Antonio, they've gone 4 of 8 in this fourth quarter, shooting an even 50% from the field. Here's Parker with the three. Gasol with the rebound.
You know what? He's never been known as a three-point shooter. Not sure why he continues to try.
Fred with the bucket.
And that is just all Fred, demonstrating just how confident he is in himself. Put the big basket there.
Here's Parker following the basket by Fred. It's stolen by Fred. The kick out to Young. From outside, off the mark. A three from Leonard. But they get it back. Parker outside. To the inside. Here's Aldridge. Will not go. This is off the front iron. Can probably expect to see him slow it down now.
Yeah, I think you want to milk your possession. What a bucket at one of the more crucial moments of the game.
You know I love that crunch time. This is where the big time players are made.
San Antonio calls timeout. They're trailing by 4.
Our execution has to be perfect from here on out, gentlemen. Understood? Do not tune this out again.
It's not impossible, but very improbable to say the least.
And the Spurs making a change here. There's 18 seconds left in the game. Down low, right wing, stolen by Randolph, and they commit an intentional foul. It's another one of those, so they can get into the penalty.
That's right. No other option but to foul and hope for some misses.
There's 10 seconds left in the fourth quarter, and he commits the intentional foul.
His first personal foul.
second team foul. At the line for your Grizzlies, Justice Young. Two shots.
He drops the first one, and that puts them up by five.
What you love about Young most, to me, is his work ethic. He gives every ounce of energy he has on both ends of the floor.
And so he drops them both.
That's how we play the game. Bring it in. Let's go. I love the energy, fellas. I really do. But now we got to keep it up and stay focused. Just keep squeezing that orange juice, gentlemen.
Seconds left in the fourth quarter. Ginobili with the three. Good defensive work there by Young. Krebs. So it's Memphis picking up the win. Probably a little closer than they would have liked it, but a win nonetheless.
Yeah, but I really got a sense that the fans gave them that emotional boost that was needed down the stretch. This crowd, man, they were electric.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, David Aldridge, Steve Smith, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching.
There he is.
Yo, Preds, Ernie and the guys in the studio want to talk to you.
All right, let's get it.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Thank you, Kevin. Now it's time to present our Jordan player of the game, Preds.
This is Shaq. First off, congratulations on the win. What do you think was the key factor in putting this game away?
Man, I got to say, I think we actually had a lot of mental toughness in this one. You know, there were times where we had lulls in the game, but, you know, we made sure to keep working hard, sticking to the game plan coach laid out, and that's how we were able to get the win tonight.
Well, it looked like you guys mastered the game plan tonight. Excellent job, especially by you, buddy.
Thank you very much.
That's going to do it for our broadcast tonight. We certainly hope you've enjoyed the show, don't we, guys?
It was great.
Yeah. Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, and for Kevin Harlan and the entire 2K Sports crew, all 653,000 of them.
Yeah, it's a lot.
Hardworking.
A lot of people.
Yeah. It's a long line at the buffet, though. Yeah.
Shout out to the T-Poles, man.
Oh, yes.
I don't know
sure.
his name, but I know his face.
I'm Ernie Johnson. See you next time.